do a teaching on Christ can't die two different ways. He can't be born two different ways. Cross versus a tree. Just some good things in this Bible that people aren't telling you that you, I mean, the simplest things, y'all. Let me just say this and I'm gonna wrap it up. I had a great time. Thank everybody that showed up tonight to get some of this good teaching. I pray that the Lord open your eyes. I pray that the Holy Spirit is leading you to further truth. I pray that your belief, the thing Christ said about believing is to Thomas, is Thomas, you believe because you see, you touch, you feel. But blessed are those who don't see me and believe in me, Thomas. Those are truly the blessed ones. It's right in your Bible. We run around here talking about we blessed. We just casually throw that word out there and don't even understand what the true blessing and the true covenant is. That's why I say most of us really is walking in the curse because we disobeying God. We disobeying God with the things you do in your life. You're disobeying God by the things he told you not to do or the things he told you to do, like eat pork, like keep the Sabbath. These things are more important to God than the preachers out here preaching about your sin and you living foul. Tell them to preach you the truth. You got some ministers out here, they'll post, oh, and they gave him the Messianic vinegar. And he denied it, too, because it had hyssop in it. He didn't want it, okay? What the hell that got to do with anything? He was a Hebrew. They tried to poison him on the cross, if that's what you want to say. They was trying to give him some vinegar with some hyssop in it that'll just drain his brain dead. So he hanging, whether it's from a tree or from a cross, he had to say, it is finished. And if Christ would have never said it is finished, whether it's on a cross, whether it's on a tree, it would have never been finished. Salvation wouldn't be for us. So when they tried to give him that Messianic hyssop and that Messianic vinegar, he refused it. Don't let nobody tell you he drunk that mess. Okay, sorry. I'm like trying to wave the internet back in. Excuse me. Don't let people tell you that he denied that hyssop. That would have drugged him out, and he would not have been able to say it is finished. And that's what he came to the earth to do, was to finish his assignment. And that's what we have to do on this earth today. Finish the assignment. Until we come back or until we go home, whichever comes first. You have to contend the faith. You don't go out there fighting. Like I said, I don't care less if you call him Jesus for the rest of your life. That's between you and God. Some of you Greek, Roman people should call him Jesus. That's your God. Y'all love Zeus. That's your heritage. That's who you're supposed to be praying. That's why it's probably working for most of y'all, because that's your faith. That's what you believe. But I know when I started believing in Yeshua, when I started walking in the covenant again, when I started trying to do... See, I spent a lifetime trying to quit drinking, quit smoking, fornicating. I committed adultery. Well, adultery in and of itself has to be explained. The Bible says if a man put away his wife and then go marry somebody else, he commits the adultery. If a wife put away her husband and go marry somebody else, it doesn't say if you sleep with a married man, that's adultery. Read what the Bible says. It's wrong to sleep with anybody's husband. I'm not condoning that at all. But we get adultery mixed up with a lot. We get a lot of things mixed up. Read what the context said. Christ said it out his mouth. When a man put away his wife, go marry somebody else. And another thing the Bible says, call no man master. We call him everybody master. Call no man father. Christians call spiritual father. Oh, my daddy in church. My spiritual mother. The Bible says, speak not in tongues in front of the whole congregation unless somebody is there that can actually interpret the tongues. It says, if not, you cause confusion and things must be done. What? Y'all love to say this, but you don't even know why you say decently and in order. It's talking about the office and the school of the prophets. It's talking about when there's two or three prophets there, don't let everybody get up and be prophesying together, because then everybody can't understand. He said, let one go and the rest stay back, the Bible says. When that one's finished, and it says the prophet is subject to the prophets. Nobody else supposed to be judging the prophet of God, or the prophet of God ain't supposed to be answering to nobody, apostle. You hear me? Read your word of God. They don't got to get approval from nobody. But you got people so feared. That's slavery, yo. That is slavery. That is slavery at its finest. You controlling people in the churches. You're doing a whole bunch of stuff to people that the Bible say don't do. But church, you're enslaving people by your doctrine that's not even in the Bible. So it goes on to say that if you speak in tongues and no one's there to interpret it, you should not do it. And what do you pastors do? You get up, hey, hallelujah. Who the hell understood you? I'm praying to interpret some of them tongues, because a lot of y'all sound like y'all demonic. A lot of y'all sound like y'all running around here just, and then how come all y'all sound the same? How come all y'all tongues, when the book says that everybody was given an utterance of their own language, of their own, how come everybody tongues sound the same? Man, listen, because you a fake, you a phony, you a copycat, and you ain't got no Holy Ghost up in you. You mimic what the pastor say, you go home and try to, No. Copy what? Stop speaking tongues in public, please. I ain't going there now, because this is about Emmanuel or Jesus. There's so much teaching I could do. Emmanuel or Jesus, you decide. Let your faith decide. Hear what thus saith the Lord. He called his name not one time did God. Okay, we're wrapping it up. It's almost 1 o'clock. Not one time did God prophesy his name to be Jesus. Okay? So while I'm right here, I'm just going to wrap it up with Acts 11:19 so you can see for yourself. Hold on 1 second. I'm just trying to see here. Okay. I can't. It's in 19. It says, now they which were scattered abroad upon the persecution that arose about Stephen traveled as far as Phoenicia and Cyprus and Antioch, preaching the word to none but unto Jews only. This right here is where the Christian church started. This is where they went out and started assessing the words Christians on people. So what I'm saying, guys, is there's enough information in here to change your life, to be holier than thou, if that's what you want to be right standing with God. And there's enough information in here to say, wait, we've been hashtag Religion Week. Go to YouTube, hashtag Religion Week. You'll find a lot more of this teaching over on YouTube. Go over there and subscribe. Go over there and like, share all the videos, all the teachings. If we stand in agreement, we're two or more in agreement. Christ is in the midst of us. Let me tell you, there's some believers out here that believe this. A lot of people don't know that Christ was hung on the tree, though. A lot of people don't know that Christ's name is Emmanuel, Yeshua. A lot of people don't know that a lot of the Hebrew names have been changed from Y to J's. A lot of people don't know. And like I said, God has people out here bringing you the truth. And it's up to you to believe. All you got to do is ask God to give you the... God poured out his flesh on all spirit, his spirit on all flesh. So we all have the spirit of God on us. We all have a measure of faith. It's just what you're going to do with yours. Because you got 5 million followers and you made a life of your career lying to people, sabotaging people. That's what you want to do with your life. That's fine. Remember, you got to answer to God. This bogus teaching, it says it in the Bible. You got to answer to God. All this false teaching, itchy ears and all that stuff, baby, it's right here in the Bible. Ain't nobody making this stuff up. Ain't nobody lying to you. Ain't nobody deceiving you. But the people who put this stuff in here to keep you from your truth. And the people who on Facebook, who out in the world, preaching this stuff, going mad over Jesus in this Bible, and don't even know what it is they teaching you. But see, we've been conditioned as black people, slave people, oppressed people, to just believe whatever doctrine come our way, to just accept what feel good religion works for us, to just accept what people tell us is our culture, is our truth, is our way of life. And it's really not even according to this Bible. So I debunked that already. His name is not Jesus. It is Emmanuel. It is Yeshua. It is God is with us. We can't get that with Jesus. And God knows, because we believe in Jesus and been doing it all our lives, that he know. But he won't. Come on. So yeah, so God wants us to know the truth, to be fed the truth. And this right here says, if you build your life with Jesus, then, you know, construction may have been a little rough. You may have been on a couple of detours. You may still be on the narrow road, I meant the broad road, wondering why you can't get on the narrow road, or wondering why, if you're on the narrow road, things just ain't lining up. First of all, the man name is Emmanuel, and you're not going to really be able to build much of anything. We make mistakes. Let me tell you something. The ones higher up that think they got it all under control, that think they out here leading the sheep and honey, astray. Tell them to teach you the truth. They don't even know the truth. That's why you keep hearing them post the same Bible verses year after year after year after year after year. I can stay off Facebook for I don't know how many, a year at a time, come back and you say the same thing. This is what God wants you to do. God wants you to speak, thus saith the Lord. Because this Bible is conditioned to keep you in slavery. That's why so many of y'all out here following people and not Yahweh. That's why so many of y'all people out here as Christians, man, let me tell you, you don't know what they doing to you with this word of God. But I know they're enslaving you. I know they playing that Jedi mind trick on you. I know they don't want you to worship God. They want you to worship somebody other than God, so that you will not be in covenant, so that you will not be in right standing, so that you will not be in the blessing. And they know, it's right here in the Bible. God says, if you don't obey me, whether you was tricked into it or not, because God says it's enough for you in they know you've been tricked. They know you don't know this word right here. That's why they keep feeding you the same scripture. Prosperity, the same scripture. Grace, the same. They all gonna need all of that when God get a hold of them. God said, feed my sheep. And sheep is dying left and right out here. Because what? They perish for lack of who? Knowledge. Lack of what? Knowledge. Y'all better start to could like pass the crippled dollar. I love you. He said, they keep you confused because they don't want you to connect the dots. He's been doing it 30 years and he's connecting the dots now for his congregation. Thanks be to Yahweh. But you know, they don't want you to connect the dots. They don't want you to be set free. Man, if you got set free and realize that money is not the way you get anything from God. Some churches gonna have to close their door and merge in with somebody else because you're keeping their lifestyle going. So they throw a little buffoonery in with the Bible, get you to hoop and holler and run around the church like you're crazy, and you're still crazy looking for your breakthrough. You're still crazy on Facebook and crazy in the world. You're crazy. Let me tell you something. If you were serving Jesus, God, Christ, Emmanuel, Messiah, Lamb of God, all these things you want to call this man, except for his right name, it don't matter. You won't be angry. You won't be hateful. You wouldn't give two damns of a sense who said what and how they say it. But everything someone come out of somebody's mouth, you got an attitude about it, people. You trying to post some old nasty, man, that sarcasticness in your heart, that right there is what God wants you to get out your system. Okay, you may not drink, you may not smoke, you may not fornicate, but you lie, lady. You deceive people, men. You cheat people out of their true inheritances. And these people know it. They know that it's in the Bible. God said, if you don't obey me, I'm going to give my name and my ordinance and my blessings to other people. And that's how they living over there in Israel. And you over here struggling to prove your salvation in God. Got to fight with people and argue with people to say you a better Christian or you got a better teaching. You ain't got a better nothing because God says get that wickedness out your heart. Y'all worrying about the wrong thing. See, when you get that wickedness out your heart, the rest shall follow. The rest shall follow. That's why I don't preach about what you're doing wrong. Preach about what's wrong. Our heart is wrong. What we've been teaching is wrong. We haven't renewed our mind. If you renewed your mind to this Bible, then I want you to go by Colossians 3:22. Slaves, obey your master in the flesh, not with eye service, but singleness of heart, honey. Get down on your knees and say, yes, sir. Yes, sir. That's what this Bible, parts of it do. It said it right there in Colossians 3:22. These people want you to continue to be slaves like you were with Pharaoh. You've been slaves damn near all your damn life. And this Christianity just got you more enslaved. Because what do slaves do? They argue about the food. They argue about the bread right here. Remember God said man can't live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out the mouth of God. But y'all argue over the bread. The same bread Jesus said don't give to the dogs. Mm-hmm. They're arguing over this bread. this bread. Y'all fight over this bread. But man can't live by bread alone. Y'all gotta feed the sheep. You gotta feed the sheep. Like I said, if your crew, your clique, your people, your chick don't know Jesus, well, maybe people don't know Jesus love. But if they don't know Emmanuel love,